for waking us up to see the beauty of another day. Thank you for your protection over us. Thank you for your mercy that endures forever. This is a day you have made again, and it is your intention that we should rejoice in this day. So we have come before your throne of mercy, Lord, to tap into your word that have the potency of giving us that joy. Let the joy become our portion today in the name of Jesus. Let the beauty of this your word gladden our hearts, and let the truth of your word order our path. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Welcome to another time with God on Glorious Morning Shower. This is the day the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Glorious Morning Shower, we all know, is a devotional platform. And we thank God for what God is doing with us. We thank God for keeping us on this network for the last 1 year. We want to thank as many who are giving us support there. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. The word for your shower today is gaining access to generational blessings. It's so sympathetic that many around this Africa region leave courses for their children and children, grandchildren yet unborn. You see, it was a pattern before God broke it. See, the sin of the father usually visit the son. The father did something wrong and he's long gone. You know, he said he visits the iniquity of a father even to the fourth generation. So that means many are under the kind of bondage of causes that their great grandfather committed. But over there also in the civilized world, like in the developed world, you hear establishments that have lived many years. For instance, Ford, that we are using the vehicle down in Africa countries today, you know, from history, was founded by Henry Ford. Now, children yet unborn are still benefiting from the blessings of Henry Ford of many years ago. So, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, great-great-grandchildren of Henry Ford have access to that generational blessings. And today, God wants me to let you know that that is how it is too, that we also have access to that kind of blessing that Abraham enjoyed with God thousands of years ago. And how can we access a generational blessing? And God wants in the month of November to break every curse that your lineage brought into your life that has espoused you into some kind of torment, lack, poverty. He wants to break it by understanding of scripture, by positive confession, by obeying some certain principles after the Abrahamic order, removing yourself from that root that communicates that cause, and get connected to the root of Abraham, so that you can begin to enjoy that Abrahamic blessing. The book of Galatians chapter 3 verse 13 to 14 says, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is every man that hangeth on a tree. Now, look at verse 14. He says, that the blessing of Abraham might become on the Gentiles through Jesus. You and I are Gentiles. We are not Jews. He said, but the death of Jesus Christ has redeemed you from that your biological curse of your family that has been giving you some kind of negativity, poverty, lack, backwardness. You know, there are some family you notice that they have this thing they call near to success syndrome. They will get close to it, it will dissolve. If you go to that family, many of the children didn't complete school. Some rusticated, some close to it, they begin to have mental problem, go back, you know, in marriage, you know, you see that they begin to have children but not married. You understand? You see a young girl in that kind of a home, you know, have 3-4 children but different fathers. You see, you can even trace it to that there. If you go home, you see a house uncompleted by their grandfather or by their father, who may not be alive again, or who may even be alive, has built a house somewhere, is not completed. You see, everything they do is uncompleted. Uncompleted. It is a generational curse. So, by the death of Jesus Christ, I want this understanding. I know we believe in prayer, we believe in, you know, we believe in shouting and exercising our faith in prayer. We exercise our faith in prayer. You know, we ventilate a lot in prayer, but there is a kind of another ventilation and exercise that comes by the understanding of the word. Now, it is by reasoning that the prodigal son came out of that wood. He reasoned, how many servants does my father have? Why should I stay here and die? Does that reasoning, that understanding brought him out of that wood? And that is the kind of understanding that God wants you to have today. Remove yourself from any kind of curse that may have be on you by the virtue of your lineage. I believe this word is deep that you need to understand. We will not go too far today, but the understanding is this: the death of Jesus Christ has removed you from every generational curse that came upon us by the virtue of our biological connection to our heritage. And from today, we are connected to the blessings of Abraham. He said, so that the blessing of Abraham might be extended to the Gentiles. We have become lineage of the Abrahamic order. It's not by singing. It's not Abraham blesses am I am blessed in the morning. Yes, it's a good song to keep reminding your mind that the blessings of Abraham is yours. But have you been able to dissociate yourself from that your Africa origin that is full of idol? Have you been able to remove yourself from what you were dedicated to when you were born, that is not in church? You were not dedicated in church. You know, I was ministering in a local setting, church, and I brought this issue up. And many women came up, those that could remember, they said they have never, and we have to rededicate them back to Jesus. You were dedicated to Songo. You were dedicated to Obanje. You were dedicated to all sorts of things. And those things are following you. But I'm believing God, by the word you are hearing today, deliverance has come unto you so that we can break your lineage to any form of cause and reconnect you back to Abrahamic order of blessings. May that be your portion today in the name of Jesus. May the Lord make this word coming to you today be of a blessing to you, to gain access into a generational blessing. The blessing that you are fighting for today will not just be for you alone, but to your children yet unborn and great-grandchildren yet unborn. They will remember you for life. They will remember that a man, a woman stood at a time and disconnect us from a lineage of poverty, disconnect us from lineage of backwardness, disconnect us from lineage of lack of husband, lack of home, and she fought for it, and today we are liberated. I pray that liberation come upon you via this devotional today, in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord bless you on glorious morning shower. It is a new day for you, and may this day end on a glorious note for you, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise God.